This is Representing Truth, and in this video, I will give 50 examples of how same-sex marriage affects society, or should I say, poisons it. When this question is asked to people, they seem to stop in their tracks. Well, I plan to put a stop on that and give the proper evidence that it does affect society. So without further ado, let's go. Example 1, man divorces his wife. Yeah, that happens in any divorce. There's a lot of pain. But how much more is it when you find out that your husband is queer? Talk about rejection. That's example number 1. Example number 2 is putting salt on the wounds. A man divorces his wife and the queers celebrate. Say, oh, dude, you're being true to yourself, while that wife is devastated. And this is what you want others to embrace. How sickening. Example number 3, a husband and a father. He decides, oh, he really is a woman. Well, guess who's the first one affected? It's the spouse. Number 4, confusing role model. Oh, this is pretty obvious. Yeah, daddy. Now, my daddy is a she. Yeah, right. Really good modeling there going on, don't you think? Number 5, that kid, because of what his dad did, becoming a woman, becomes a punching bag at school. And you might say, well, hey, that happens all the time. Yes, but there's something different. The parent is allowing this to happen, and it's making it available for the other kids to do something very bad to that kid. Number 6, it will affect a brother or sister if they have one. Can you imagine this particular conversation? Hey, how's Sam, your brother, doing? What should be the response? She's doing fine? Talk about stupidity at its finest. What a predicament a parent is put in. This is number 7. When their son or daughter says, hey, I'm not your daughter, I am your son. Talk about an embarrassment to the family. It's called sexual confusion, and that is not logical. Number 8, our neighbor next door, the girl that used to play with our daughter, she got in high school and lo and behold, she believes now she is a man. So there is another example of how this stuff gets affected very personally. Number 9, I call name changing. This same neighbor, her, that thinks she's a he, came over during my son's graduation party and wanted to be with the guys. My wife called her by her name that we have known her for the last 5 years, and she was offended. And you say this stuff doesn't affect anybody? Fat chance. Number 10, coworkers are affected. Come on, if you work in a certain environment under close conditions, your coworkers just may be a little more leery how they bend down. It's true. Some people think that way, maybe not all, but these are ways in which it will affect society. Number 11, queers starting families. In the natural, impossible. Maybe through a relative, maybe through adoption, maybe through artificial means, or through a heterosexual relationship. But by themselves, it is impossible. The only way a queer family can be is to take from the family. That's why it's against the family. It can only take, but it cannot give. Number 12, two Christian doctors are sued because a lesbian is not helped by them to have children artificially. And I'm sure the radical queer agenda thinks this is wonderful. I guess freedom of religion must bow to the radical gay agenda. That is number 12. Example 13, redefining marriage. I remember when we lost our mom, she was 59 years of age. My dad got remarried. That lady became my stepmother. Though my dad would never do such a thing, hypothetically, if my dad were to marry a man, what would we call the man? And for all you idiots out there to say, well, duh, that's his partner. You have to understand one thing. It's hard enough adjusting to a new wife of your dad, but what would a little kid call the other man? That is pure confusion, and it's very illogical in my view. Number 14, Christians getting demonized. And my first example is this. They believe that it is an abomination to have same-sex marriage. But Muslims also believe that, and yet it seems, at least in my view, that the majority of Muslims are not picked on and called bigots and homophobes, but only the Christians. So why do you favor your criticism to Christians but not to Muslims if you really believe that Christians are so evil? Number 15, the trick question, designed to either shut you down or make you look stupid. Here's the example. When did you choose to be straight? That's why I need to address this. See, if you buy an iPhone, and I'm an Android user myself, there's only one operating system you're going to get on that phone, which is iOS. That's the way Apple did it by default. So when someone buys an iPhone, they don't choose that operating system because it's on by default. Now, if someone jailbreaks their iPhone and puts something else on it, then that is a choice. It's the same thing whether you want to use God, nature, evolution, whatever you want to use. Remember, by default, you have male organs that fit in female organs. Do you get the picture yet? Number 15 was a trick question. This now is a trick statement. Usually when someone's in sin, they usually say, "Don't judge me. Who are you to judge?" But if you examine that statement, then once you question this, how do you know someone is judging you unless you've made a judgment yourself that they are judging you? And this whole particular statement is meant to shut someone down. It's meant to silence their opposition. And that's what the radical queer agenda attempts to do. Example 17, a bunch of lesbians decided to go to a church in Michigan and have the audacity to throw condoms in the sanctuary. Now, if you're not religious, I would think someone would respect something. You know, Christians are usually accused of shoving things down people's throats. But to defile a sanctuary like that just shows how low in the gutter this radical queer agenda really is. Number 18, an outlet for hatred. Just go on Apologetics, my daughter's account, and you will see many hateful comments directed toward her. So this is a perfect excuse because they can't really pick on the blacks anymore because that would be a racist. So what do? They demonize Christians, and it becomes their outlet to be hateful. And they do a very good job of it. But like Star Wars, you remember when you had Darth Vader trying to get his son to come over to the dark side? We say, no way, and you can go pound sand. Number 19, if same-sex marriage became the law federally, not just with the states, it is said that they would have over 1,000 rights and provisions. I'm not going to argue with that because the video that I am presenting is dealing with how same-sex marriage will affect society. Now, some of those particular rights and privileges, the only way you can get it, you have to interact, like social services or welfare or insurance, etc., etc., etc. You have to interact with society. And because of that, it does affect society. That's my point. Number 20, a son or daughter decides to come out and say they are homosexual. You get the picture, it affects the family, friends, etc. That is number 20. Number 21, change of perspective. Basically, those that were staunch against this particular issue are now all for this particular issue. I agree that we should love our kids unconditionally, but we are not to accept their actions unconditionally. If your son is stealing, if he's lying, if he's cheating, if he's a drunk, we should not accept those actions. What we do is we love them through those actions. And there is power to change. But the radical queer agenda has made that a lie that people have bought into. Number 22, not a blessed wedding day. And I'm speaking of the norm, not the exception. Many of the same-sex couples that get married do so with only a few people involved. They do not have the joy of having many family and friends come to their wedding. They truly don't have that acceptance, and they never will have that acceptance, no matter how hard they try to push it down our throats. And that's a sad thing, because a wedding day should be something joyful and happy, but they can never experience the true joy that comes in a real wedding. Number 23, the father giving away the bride. In a same-sex wedding, this can never happen, because with two males or two females in a wedding, the father can never have that joy that he would have had it been a real wedding. Number 24, another thing that takes away from the family, and it will affect certain fathers. See, I did give away my daughter, but I didn't gain my daughter's partner. I gained a son. Number 25, Chick-fil-A. Okay, so how many regular couples do you know make out at any restaurant? But the queers really gotta show their moral standards, not by a guy kissing another guy, but that same guy kissing more than one. My daughter and I watched it, and we saw how totally disrespectful to families they are, and they want us to embrace them? I don't think so. How about the lowering of sexual standards? Well, what exactly is the standard when it comes to homosexuals? Because if a parent says to their daughter, no messing around till you get married, and the daughter responds, well, that's not fair because my brother is a queer and he messes around with his boyfriend, and how come he can mess around and I can't? Number 27, unfair to compare queers to pedophiles or having sex with an animal, but it is fair to give a guilt trip to Christians when a gay commits suicide, for any gay that gets beat up or gets murdered. We just blame the Christians because they believe that stuff. But let's take a hypothetical. Let's see how this will affect you. And how would this affect society? You have a man and a woman. He goes off to war. He dies. Now, he did have an 18-year-old daughter when he died. The wife and the daughter are very heartbroken over it. Should the mother and daughter be allowed to marry? If so, why do you say that? And how would that affect society? And if not, why are you discriminating against them? I thought that was only for the Christians to do. So let me know where you stand on that, please. Thank you. Number 28, broken friendships. I've learned this when one of the guys that went to Bible college, I called him out on this queer crap. And guess what? We are no longer friends. Not only I, but my roommate in college was willing to help him with counseling. And guess what? He is now no longer friends either. So it breaks up friends because of this perversion. Number 29, Elizabeth, it's a big one. Yep, my YouTube account, Representing Truth, was terminated because of too much offensive material on this particular matter. Number 30, film creativity. Of course, Christians, yes, have done some of this. I agree. But Mr. Glad, that queer prophet website, they really like to go after anyone that has the audacity to put any kind of gay, lesbian, bisexual, or transgender in a bad light in their film. They try to staunch that creativity. And you know what? Most of the time, Hollywood actually listens, but they don't listen most of the time to the Christian. Number 31, comedians. Oh, Richard Pryor. Oh, boy, the way he talks about God and the way he talks about Christians, it's pretty vulgar. Some would say pretty funny, too. And you know what? There's a lot of comedians today that continue that tradition. But when they slip up and they say something bad, bad about the GLBT community, yeah, something bad begins to happen in their career. And many times they will apologize. But as far as the Christian, they're given the one finger salute while they bow to the God of glad. It's unfortunate, but that's reality today. And that's how it affects comedians. Number 32, eHarmony.com, a Christian dating service, got sued by some queers, and they lost. And because of that, now same-sex partners